Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in Goldcrest Valley, we're in front of Morgan's Massive Motors, in our Massey Ferguson. Anyway, I wanted to show you something. Let's go over here to the store. And if you look at your garage, double-click here. I guess single-click, okay? These are all the items that you own. If you grab the arrow at the corner, either one, you get to the items that you have leased. So you can return them from here, from just hitting P on your keyboard from anywhere in the map. There's no bonus to bringing it to the store to return it like there is for selling an item at the store. That you get, 10 to 20% bonus. But this one, you've already paid it. So we're going to return this one. It was fun to see, but it's not something that we're going to use again. We'll stick to the equipment that we've got. Return this? Yes. All right, it's been returned. All right, so back, and today we want to what? We're going to, let's go back to baling technology. That's where we're up to. Where am I? Right there. Okay, so we picked up last time this square baler. We've got the square wrapper. Actually, this will wrap, I believe, square and round. I wish it would say so in the description, but it does not. But we got that guy, and then this guy right here rounds them all up. So this guy we're going to use first. Now, nothing else that's important to see there. This one, same thing, other than it does 16. All right, so let's grab this guy. Select foil color. Okay. What do we want? I kind of like the dark. I'm thinking it will absorb heat more so that it will cook the, heat up and get the fermenting process going quicker. Kind of like the off green as well. Let's go with this one. That's a little different. So by that, we can change that at our own farm over there at the maintenance shack. All right, so back, and back. Yeah, there it is. Let's dive out over here. Man, that's a tall tractor. That wheel's as big as I am. This is quite the fancy setup. All of our extra packages of wrapping right there. Yeah, that's neat. Okay, grab him. Let me back up a little so I can see where I'm... Let's try that again. See where I'm going. See, he's coming off at an angle here. Interesting. So let's hook him up. And I see that pivots out to match us. So it's on a pivot down there. Aha. When we unfold it, he kicks way off to the side. Hello. There we go. This time I think I'll drive home. I won't clip this one out. We haven't actually driven back from the store in quite some time. Jump in cab here. There was some lag. See if that came over in the recording. Sometimes I wonder what the what I see on the screen compares to what hits the recorder. Doesn't always match up. When I see really bad lag at the end of a long episode on the screen here, I notice it's smoothed out pretty good on the recorder. Now, I'm also seeing 60 frames a minute, or a second, 60 frames a second here, but Fraps is set to record at 30 frames per second. So, I guess what I am seeing here is a little bit different. Anyway, I'm rambling on, but this is our turn here. Do we want to do this now? Tell you what, let's go finish the baling. Then we'll open up this surprise. And let's see, from here, I think I just need to hit tab. Nope, I have to hit shift tab. There we are, there's the warrior. Okay, let's finish off all the grass we can find here. That means what? X is already done, so V, B. There we go. And this won't take long at all because I don't have to stop. I don't have to pause for anything. In fact, I don't even have to be out here. I can be in here, enjoying the quiet and comfort of the cab of my new tractor. Although you guys won't get to see all the show out here. And the square baler does put on quite the good show. So let's keep that available to you. Once I go around this corner, try to look at it from the side. There we go. Zoom in here a little bit. Watch how this works. Woohoo! I'm going to get a lot of bales out of this field. It's all been fertilized. What we'll do next is run the plow through here and add even 10% more bonus to it. Let me get up here where I can see this a little better. There we go. That's looking good. But I've not actually run the square silage wrapper, bale wrapper, before. I've only seen it in a video, and then only for a few seconds, this tiny little clip that they included. So I would like to see how this works too. Now, see if I can run a straight line while I'm looking around. That noise it makes, it kind of sounds like a cow munching at the feeding trough. But I miss anything out over there? I need a snag with this baler? I don't think so. It looks pretty clean. I've made all these turns just right. Okay, we'll grab this one and get over to the other side. There's some random noises. I don't know that there's actually an air pump in there, but it sounds like a mechanically kind of noise. Like the air brakes on a semi-truck or something. Alright. Now, if I recall, there is a way to eject a bale out of here. I think I have seen Daggerwind do that. I've not run one of these in Farming Simulator 17, so I don't know that that really is the thing, but it seems like you did that once. Whoa, there was a bunch of lag. I wonder what happened in the background just then. Had a certain part of the field that it didn't like. When we get to the end, I'll hit the F1 and see what it can do. And now I'm too busy thinking about which pathway to take to line myself up with the next nearest pathway. I think I'm going to dive off in this direction and do a loop. Oh, we have something over there. Let's see if we can get into the middle of this again. Yeah, into an argument with some round bales. I want your grass. Ah, you're gonna split? You're gonna split. Great. Let's do that. Yeah, the big munching cow down there. Boom. 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 We are almost done. Who knows if we're going to actually find all of those round bales. Maybe some rolling around in town. And oh, there's a little bit right there to catch. Okay, like that. Now this guy, well, he might kick off to a side. No, he's going to track me. Boy, he is. Okay, well, we'll do this then. Send you to there, and we'll back up. Continue. Don't do this at home. It kind of ruins silage bales. Kind of tears the foil. Okay, one more loop. Maybe some touch-ups and we're done. Hard to differentiate the rows of grass sometimes from the backgrounds. I don't think there's any hiding in there. Ah, there's one little spot way off there to the left corner, left side. But we'll get this. We'll catch that other spot next time we mow. Alright, Just back up a little bit so we can see this last bale come tumbling off. All right, are we done? I think so. All right, now, what I want to know is, do we have a way to kick out a last bale? Turn off baler, lift pickup. Oh, the pickup head is the little guy in front. Cruise, if I turn off the engine, no, that doesn't add anything. I add the click, nope. So I guess there is not a way. Z does nothing in here? Does not. Okay, so if I were to hit X to fold up, what would happen? It will not. Interesting. Now what I've done in the past, if that guy is just out enough, I drive really fast and really squirrely swinging around and he just goes flipping off into the distance and then I can close it up. Yeah, of course I'm going to try it. Let's get a little speed up here. Without breaking a bale, though. So, nope. Not enough momentum. Okay, he's still got a good grip on it. Where do we park this guy? I'm tempted to sell the round baler and the round wrapper. What do you guys think? I won't do it this time. So, leave some comments for me. Do we still want to see the round operation done individually with those two units? No, with the yellow one there and the wrapper, which is over at the farm underneath the roof over there with the trailers. Do we want to sell those off and recoup some of the monies? Or do we want to still get a chance to see that again in a few episodes? Yeah, let me know what you think. Otherwise, I can't kick this guy off and I can't walk out and knock him off of here, right? No, I can't. But I had to try. But let's, for now, let's just park this guy over here. Just like so. Okay, let's jump into the Massey over here. And see what this guy is all about. X does what? Ooh. I'm having fun just watching it. And he kicks off to the side here. Now, 85 liters of gas. Ooh, I'm getting low. So, what choices do we have? We can fold. Change cruise control option. Okay, there's the cruise control for the tractor. If I hit G, that's something I didn't do in the other one. Wait a minute here. I gotta do that. Shift, tab. Yeah. G. No other options. Okay. Normally wouldn't be anyway. Except I think it was with the harvester that it really surprised me that even though there's only one attachment and that's the header, when I hit G, it changed the controls just for the header. It didn't combine the harvester and the header into one menu like this is obviously doing. Hit G here doesn't do any good because there's only one implement. But on a harvester, there's only one implement too. That's the header. But there, it makes a difference. Anyway, enough rambling. Exit vehicle, there's really nothing. Though I imagine a Y will show up when we have a bale in place. So let's stick a bale in place and see what happens. Now, how well does he line up? I guess if we just get him next to the wheels, he'll drop right into place. There he goes all by himself. So I must have some kind of a detector. I want to see this. And I want to see if it just drops it on its own. Or if I have to do something to release. Boy, that's a lot of wrapping. Oh, look at those knives. Okay, I've got to hit Y. That was exciting. Okay. So we could... let's think about this. First of all, how best to line this up? Yeah, that's going to be an issue, isn't it? We're going to really hit this thing carefully. Okay. Well, we'll go for this one. But it will hold on to it. So I could drive this thing around right there and leave it in a certain place. Let's see how best for to make it easier to pick up the pick the bales up afterward. So if I were to do this, okay, just kind of leave them in a line. Otherwise, let me get this guy out of here. Remember, I've got tunnel vision, so I can just drive and not even notice that big old black box right in my view. Here we go. So we can, I guess we could have done this with the round ones too, except they're still going to roll away anyway. But we can kind of gather them all up and deposit them into a similar area in the field while we've got nothing to do but just watch this guy rap. Rip. Cool. Why? So I kind of need to get Y set up to my my mouse. So dive off to the side here. Yeah, it's going to be hard to get them near each other or too close to each other because, you know, this guy really kind of bounces into the pathway all the time. We can at least get them all to the same half of the field. That's fair. Look at those rollers down there. I'm like a kid in a candy store. Slice them off. And let's grab this one while we're here before we bury him too badly. There we go. And we'll let him loose right over in here. So question is, do I make you guys watch every single one of these things? How many are out there? See if I can drive and aim and count at the same time. I guarantee you I can't. No, I can't. Let me just aim this guy. Pull into there. I've got to be looking down. There we are. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 22, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 31. There's a lot. Okay, so I'll tell you what, I am going to time-lapse the rest of this so we can spend some time grabbing that collector, bale collector, and go and pick up the bales. So I'll catch you on the other side, folks. Time lapses. I always speed it up to 10 times, so 1,000%. So I would imagine that looked kind of like, you know, what we farmers call the farmer's ballet. Kind of like our version of Olympic ice skating. You see the triple Lutz back there? That is impressive. Is that the last one? I think I've got them all. Okay. Now, I'm sure there's one thing that's been going through all of your minds, and you're all kind of wondering, Will he do it? Will he do it? You all want to know what happens if you drive over a wrapped bale. Will it try to wrap it again? This bale is not supported. Ah, I wondered that too. I had to find out. Anyway, that gas gauge down there where it says 66 in red, that thing has been getting angrier and angrier the whole time. So let's grab the warrior over here and drive that one instead. And go get a bale collector. Alright, set that there. So we're just kind of stuck with the with a bale being pooped out the end there, and not a thing we can do about it. Anyway, I'll be over at the store. I'll catch you there. Yeah, I know. He really had to go there, huh? Excuse me. Hello. But let's grab the large square bale collector. Baling technology, this guy, the Kuhn, we'll call it that, the FSX63.72, $70,000. That's going to take us down to $4 million. Probably won't have time to do any selling this time, but maybe next episode we'll sell all of those bales and see how much we can recoup, because that's going to be just about right. So select, no choices. I did get the right one, right? You are collector, eases a collection of bales. 16 bales? Yeah, I'm pretty sure you're the right one. Buy you, yes, uh-huh, okay, back. Now, I didn't do a lot of baling in Farming Simulator 15, so 13's where I did this for hours upon hours upon hours on end. We didn't have silage bale wrapping back then. So, that wasn't invented yet. So, we just baled them to drop into the foraging wagons to mix up the total mix rations and stuff like that. This guy, fun to watch. Kind of like the little round bale collector, in the sense there's lots of mechanisms that move around as you throw them in. This guy over here drops down and scoops him up. And I'm going where? I think I already missed it. I need to take this turn right here. Sneak through there. The warrior is becoming the terror of the town. Yeah, you did make a little turn there. Okay. Yeah, I didn't hit you. Cool. Didn't have to bring in the insurance company this time. Alright. Now, when I snip little pieces out here and there and do a time lapse, I have no idea how many minutes into this I am. Let's X. That didn't work. B. There we go. So he drops down. He scoops them up. I would imagine that there's a conveyor belt into that. Drops off into here. And flips it, I believe, into that. Let's watch this happen. Hopefully he handles the wrapped ones just as easy as the non-wrapped ones. A little harder to hit this one. Ah, that's right, he goes that direction. Okay. So now to navigate a pathway through our minefield here. Just like so. Now he flips them up on end. Up against these two forks over here. Go. Grab another one. And he moves back a row. Pretty soon we're going to have just a mountain here. Okay, well, he's moving into place. We'll pick our next victim. Right there. So two of them, about as fast as you can drive into them. Then you've got a long pause, maybe time to line up another two. All the machinery moves back into place, and we'll head in and grab this guy, and this guy. Whoops. Well, he was very very graceful, or gave me some grace there. It's not easy to do this in the cab. I mean, it can be done, but it's kind of, you just have to get used to where it lands. You got to just line up these wheels. Let's go for this one over here. Just drive right alongside of it. Like so. He grabs it. Okay. And what do we got? None of these are in the right direction. We'll grab this one. Pretty soon we're going to be at the end of this. What do you think? One more row? Seven in there. So yeah, one more row. So I think we'll go and sell this first one immediately. And again, looking at the numbers up there, I don't think I can get that one. Well, kind of did. Okay. $4 million. We'll say it's $4 million even. Oh, he's struggling. Okay, B folds that up. Let's drive over to our barn and sell this guy. Now, you guys can just start doing some math in your heads. This is my third episode in a row tonight. So I'm having so much fun with all the Kuhn pack equipment choices. This has been a lot of fun these last three episodes. So my brain is not here completely right now. You can tell me what 16 times 1475? Oh, wow. That's a pretty decent engine in that thing, and I am struggling. There's a lot of weight here. Okay, what's 16 times 4,000? That's 48,000 liters. Okay. Divided by 4. Yeah, okay, I lost it. Anyway, divide it by 4, and it gives you how many pounds? No. Anyway, how many gallons? Yeah. And then 7 pounds per gallon, and about 2,000 pounds per ton. When you work through all that, you'll see how much weight we're actually carrying here. But again, I'm ready to go to bed. Get this episode done. And get some editing done tonight so I can try to get a couple of these out tomorrow. Right about there. Now, why on the other trailer did it? So, looks like it does on this one, too. Not quite lined up straight, but we'll land... What was that? That guy just went past a chicken. Alright, are we within the zone? Let's back up just a touch. That's not the backup. There's the backup. And why? Alright, here we go. 4 million becomes... 28,000. Wow. So $28,000. Oh, 1,764. I did not expect that. I mean, I really didn't expect that. It's still 4,000 liters. Remember when I said last, was that last time or was, I think it was the end of last episode. Hello. Hey, we're in the loft. You know, 4,000 liter bale should be a 4,000 liter bale should be a 4,000 liter bale. But it's Farming Simulator, so sometimes it's not, and apparently it's not. So 1764 for all of those. Now I've got my curiosity going. Is that because that's what silage was selling for at that moment? Okay, I gotta know. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to go round up another trailer full and come back. That way the video doesn't get too long. I'll be right back. Let's see if it is the same or if that drops significantly because we've just really messed with supply and demand. So be right back. Okay, so we've got at least another half a trailer still out there. But... when I dumped that first bucket of loose silage, it shocked me how much it was. And then when I dumped the second bucket, an episode later, or two episodes later, it shocked me how little it was. Meaning, we hadn't sold silage in any form for a long time. So it was almost $1,700 for a 4,000 liter bucket's worth. which is the same as a bale. And so I'm curious if these were up high in price because we hadn't sold anything for quite a long time. Let's find out what happens here. Why? 1764s all the way through. Okay, so it doesn't drop because we've sold a whole bunch, of, you know, supply and demand. So next thing that has to be answered before I can call this episode complete and, you know, satisfactory, I need to see if the round ones are still the 1450 or 1475 that I'm remembering. In which case, we definitely want to be working only in square bales nowadays, or from now on. No more round ones, because that's where the money is. So let's... I think I've got to go wide. This is a pretty short turning radius on this trailer. See, right there he starts to hit. So let's... Although I don't really have a good space to put this into right now. Let's just park it over here and go grab the round collector. And we'll do that. So, Q, drop him off. And I think I'm just going to have to accept the fact this is going to be a long episode. So I'll go ahead and drive over there with you guys. I'll let you drive with me. Is that a better way to say that? Alright, this does not have anything in it. Good. The wrapper does. I'll have to sell that off before we take it back. But I think that kind of answers the question of last episode, whether we should keep the small round equipment. I don't think there's any real value to it now. But we'll verify that. I want to see 14 something per bale. But just like that, we've got 60,000 back. So we were in 8,000 and 10,000 roughly into those two leases. So you can see how leasing equipment to make silage bales out of does pay for the equipment and leave you quite a bit of surplus. So it can be done on a lease program if you choose to. So it's always best long term to buy the equipment and use it enough times to really pay for everything. I want to clip out these big segments, or time-lapse these big segments. I'm always left wondering, at the end, if I remembered all the things I was thinking about. I've got to be sure to tell you when I start recording again. Actually, it was a little easier to... we got them all here? I think so. Don't know how many rolled into the river. But a little easier to... lost my train of thought, to pick up the square bales without being recorded, because I don't have to hit them perfectly straight on and make it look good. I can just get near it. It's pretty forgiving. You get in the right vicinity and it'll grab them. Alright, this guy over here, let's get this back. Can I sneak in there? I think I can. There we go. Okay. You, and is he still out? He is. B brings that back up. Alright, let's find this road, get over the railroad tracks, and sell the stuff. And then that has got to be an episode. I don't know how long the episode is, but I've been recording for over 50 minutes. And recording this game with all of the rendering that the CPU does for this game, you know, so many things to render, plus recording the game, which is very CPU heavy. About an hour into it, I start to lag pretty bad. In fact, I might be getting there right now. And so everything just kind of gets jerky when I turn. So, hello, corner. So I don't want to run this too long or end up having to shut the game down, restart it, in order to get the end of it done. Nice to be able to keep it all in one clip here. All right, let's see how well we can do this. Ah, the Ursus T-127. These little things you don't notice. At least I don't notice. I notice a lot of things when I'm editing, though. Things that I didn't get to see while I was actually doing the episode. I think we're pretty close there. Let's jump... drop him up. Maybe when he's up in the air, I'll get a better sense. There we go. Of where I'm actually at. Is that way? Yeah. So I'm thinking I want to be right about there. In fact, I bet you I can go even a little further. I like that. All right, I'm expecting to see 14 somethings. Let's see what happens. 1764. Okay. So it's the same. We've had update 1.4, and we've had update 1.42 since we dealt with bales before. I'll bet you one of those two increased the value of silage. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if it happened right at the time or just before I dumped that bucket of loose silage in. I'd be curious if it happened back then. But anyway, with that, I think I'm going to have to call this one done. But that was an interesting development. Silage is worth more. That's good. That makes it worth doing it. Anyway, this has been Noble Rambler. I thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.